Mary Berry is going to show us a few easy and inexpensive dishes for one-ring cooking. Hello, Mary.
Hello, Judith.
And in the second half of the programme, she'll be telling us about some appetising salads to use when everything else breaks down in the kitchen. Well, Mary, what have you worked out, first of all, with this stuff here?
I thought a casserole would be a good idea because we're asked to use gas at off-peak times, and if you were having lunch, an off-peak time would be soon after breakfast to put a casserole on, and then it would be ready for an early lunch.
So you're going to put this on at 9 o'clock in the morning?
That's right.
Bright and early.
This is Bristol beef casserole, and I'm using a pound of steak, stewing steak, for four people. Now, I used to use a pound and a half for four people, but as the price of meat has gone up, I'm now putting more vegetables in my casseroles and not quite so much meat.
May I just make it clear that Bristol beef is the name you've given it? It's not a particular kind of beef.
Indeed not, no. Then I'm putting three onions in with the beef. All the vegetables go with this recipe, and the great joy is that you don't have a great frying session before you start, because many casseroles you have to fry all the beef and the vegetables, and this takes time, and you've also got to watch it. And this means that you can get the whole thing together, you time it, in a very few minutes. So there's three onions in and three carrots chopped up on top. And then we need the juice to go in, and a small can of tomato soup makes an excellent flavour, and I add a stock cube so that it isn't noticeably tomato soup. One stock cube, meat stock cube.
And that is not condensed soup, I hasten to add, is it? It's just the ordinary.
Ordinary.
Sort of
thickness. And that would make it a little bit runny. And I'm going to add a little bit more juice because I like quite a bit of juice with my stews. And I'm going to add a full can of water. But it needs thickening up, it would be too runny. So I'm going to add a tablespoonful of flour,
ordinary,
1 ounce.
Ordinary flour?
Exactly, yes. 1 ounce is a rounded tablespoonful into the can to save the washing up. And then fill it up with water, but I'm going to just mix it to a paste in the bottom so it doesn't go in lumpy. It isn't important to make it absolutely smooth because it's all cold liquid. If it was a boiling liquid, you know, sometimes when you make a sauce by the blending method and you pour it in, it goes lumpy immediately because it's all hot. This is all cold, so it won't. There we are, up to the top. So there's no need for me to give you measurements of pints and what have you. It's just the can. There we are. Salt.
How much do you think this will cost, all these ingredients you've got in here, to make this casserole?
About 65p.
Very reasonable.
So that's reasonable for four, isn't it? Mm. And pepper. You don't need to want to add too much salt. In a normal recipe, I use a teaspoonful to the pound of meat, a little bit less with the stock cube. So there we are, put the lid on and let it simmer for about 3 hours. Bring to the boil and simmer for about 3 hours. Now that would be ready if you put it in at 9, just before 12. Now you may well have a family that...
Doesn't want to eat till 1:30, say.
Well, a good idea is to use the old hay box method. I say hay box method. Do you remember? Well, perhaps you weren't a girl guide.
I wasn't, actually.
Well, I was, and we used to at guide camp have a big, great big packing case filled with straw, and you put cooked hot dishes in it, and they remained hot for 3 hours. So a quicker version of this is wrapping a casserole in first of all newspapers and then a bath towel, and you'll be amazed how hot it will keep. So it means you're not cooking at peak times.
Good.
Is that hot?
Yes. Very
gracious.
Hot.
It's too hot to lift.
How long will that stay hot, Mary? Well, oh, that's marvellous.
It will stay hot depending on how much newspaper three newspapers, it would keep hot 3 hours. And then a towel around the outside. It's a jolly good tip when you're going on picnics too, to have hot things in. You can put them in the boot of the car. Would you like to taste it?
Lovely. Gorgeous smell. Really super. I can see the steam coming up. Oh, gosh, I've got a bit on the... There.
You will nearly burn yourself, I warn you.
I have, thanks very much. But the flavour is lovely for 65 people, Cass. That's marvellous.
There we are, let's
do that in the morning.